Wisdom, the final frontier to true knowledge. Welcome to Wisdom Trek, where our mission is to create a legacy of wisdom, to seek out discernment and insights, to boldly grow where few have chosen to grow before. Hello, my friend. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, your captain on our journey to increase wisdom and create a living legacy. Thank you for joining us today as we explore wisdom on our second millennium of podcast. Today is day 1543 of our trek, and our focus on Friday is future technologies and societal advancements, so we call it Futuristic Fridays. My personality is one that I've always been very future-oriented. Since my childhood, I have yearned for the exploration and discovery of new technologies and advancements for the future. I grew up on an original Star Trek series, and even today, as I'm on my 65th revolution around the sun, I still dream of traveling into space. Each week, we will explore rapidly converging technologies and advancements, which will radically change our lives. At times, these topics may sound like something out of a science fiction novel, but each of these areas we explore is already well on its way of becoming a reality over the next couple of decades. To keep with our Ask Gramps theme, I will put our weekly topics in the form of a question to get us on track. This week's question is, hey Gramps, there's been robotics in factories for years helping to streamline manufacturing. How soon will robotics be a major impact in the retail sector? So today's subject will be, the robots are coming. For our episode today, I am using some of the information from Peter Diamandis' blog and his newly released book, The Future is Faster Than You Think. The robots are coming on our sidewalks, in our skies, and in our every store. Over the next couple of decades, robots will enter the mainstream of retail. The numbers back it up. In the last 8 years, the global retail robotics market is projected to grow an order of magnitude from $4.7 billion in 2018 to $41.67 billion in 2026. As countless robots work behind the scenes to stock shelves, serve customers, and deliver products to our doorsteps, the speed of retail will continue to increase. These changes were well underway, and the pandemic has accelerated them. So let's dive in a few certain areas. The first one is robot delivery. On August 3, 2016, Domino's Pizza introduced the Domino Robotic Unit, or DRU for short, the first home delivery pizza robot. The DRU is a cross between R2-D2 and an oversized microwave. LiDAR and GPS sensors help it navigate, while temperature sensors keep the food hot or the food cold, depending on its need. Now called DOM, which is also the name for Domino's chatbot for placing orders, the robot has been undergoing trial runs in 10 countries, including New Zealand, France, and Germany. The August 2016 debut was critical, as it was the first time we had seen robotic home delivery. But it is not the last. A dozen or so different delivery robots are fast entering the market. Starship Technologies, for instance, a startup created by Skype founders Janice Ferris and Ati Haila, has a general-purpose home delivery robot. Right now, the system is an array of cameras and GPS sensors. Still upcoming models will include microphones, speakers, and even the ability to communicate with the customer via AI-driven natural language processing. Since 2016, Starship has already carried out more than 500,000 deliveries across more than 20 countries. Along similar lines, Nuro, co-founded by Jiajin Zhu, one of the engineers who helped develop Google's self-driving car, has a miniature self-driving car of its own. It's about half the size of a sedan. The Nuro looks sort of like a toaster on wheels, except with a mission. This toaster is designed to carry cargo, originally about 12 bags of groceries, which it has been doing for select Kroger stores since 2018. 2 years later, the company has a new second-generation vehicle with a range of new features, including improved capacity, battery life, and safety measures. Concurrently, Nuro has partnered with large chains such as CVS Pharmacy and Walmart. As these delivery bots take to our streets, others are streaking across the sky. In 2016, Amazon came first, pronouncing Prime Air. The e-commerce's giant's promise of drone delivery in 30 minutes or less. Almost immediately, companies ranging from 7-Eleven and Walmart to Google to Alibaba jumped on the bandwagon. Fast forward to today, and the FAA has granted approval for drone delivery to Amazon, Alphabet/Google's Wing project, and UPS. Prime Air's Vice President David Carbon emphasized this certification is an important step forward for Prime Air as it indicates the FAA's confidence for an autonomous drone delivery service. But what about in-store robots? While the delivery bots start to spare our trips to the store, those who prefer shopping in the old-fashioned way, that is to say in person, also have plenty of human-robot interaction in-store. These robotic solutions have been around for quite some time. In 2010, SoftBank introduced a bot called Pepper, this humanoid robot capable of understanding human emotion. Pepper's sort of cute, 4 foot tall, with a white plastic body, 2 black eyes, and a dark slash for its mouth, and the base is shaped sort of like a mermaid's tail. Across its chest is a touchscreen to aid in communication. There's been a lot of communication. Pepper's cuteness is international, and it matches its mission. It helps humans to enjoy life as much as possible. Over 12,000 Peppers have been sold, and over 2,000 companies globally have adopted Pepper as an assistant. She serves ice cream in Japan, greets eaters at Pizza Hut in Singapore, and interacts with customers at a Palo Alto's electronics store. With the COVID-19 pandemic, Pepper has been used to prepare food, greet customers, and ease loneliness caused by social distancing. More importantly, Pepper's got company. Walmart uses shelf-stocking robots for inventory control. Best Buy uses robo-cashiers, allowing select locations to operate 24/7. Lowe's Home Improvement employs Lobot, a giant iPad on wheels, to help customers find the items they need while tracking inventory along the way. Well, let's move on to warehouse bots. The most significant benefit robots provide might be in warehouse logistics. In 2012, when Amazon paid out $775 million for Kiva systems, few could predict that just 8 years later, over 200,000 Kiva robots would be deployed in the company's fulfillment centers, helping to process hundreds of items per second. Many other retailers are following suit. For instance, order a pair of jeans from Gap, and soon they'll be sorted, packed, and shipped by the help of a Kindred robot. Remember the old arcade game where you picked up a teddy bear with a giant claw? That's Kindred, only her claws pick up t-shirts, pants, and the like, placing them in designated drop-off zones that resemble tiny mailboxes for further sorting and shipping. The big deal here is democratization. A Kindred robot is cheap and easy to deploy, allowing smaller companies to compete with the giants like Amazon. And some final thoughts here on the robots are coming. For retailers interested in staying in business, there doesn't seem to be much of a choice. It is the way of the robotics. It's becoming increasingly difficult for store owners to justify human workers who call in sick, show up late, and easily get injured. Robots work 24/7 and never take a day off. They never need a bathroom break, health insurance, or parental leave. As it's been over the years, as we advance, this spells a growing challenge for technological unemployment. In retail, robotics usher in a tremendous benefit for companies and customers alike. While professional retooling initiatives and the transition of human capital from retail logistics to a booming experience economy take hold, robotic retail interaction and the last mile delivery will fundamentally transform our relationship with commerce. And as a Christ follower, we need to be able to help others who may be displaced by technology and help them to learn new careers. Technological unemployment has been with us since the creation of humankind. And as we build God's kingdom here on earth, we need to prepare ourselves to assist others whenever we have the opportunity. And this reminds me of Proverbs chapter 11, verse 25. The generous will prosper. Those who refresh others will themselves be refreshed. And that's a wrap for today's question. Join us again next Futuristic Friday as we explore another exciting exponential technology area on our Ask Gramps episode. Our next track is Meditation Monday, where we will help you to reflect on what is most important in life as we learn how to study the Bible better. So encourage your friends and family to join us and to come along with us on Monday for another day of Wisdom Track, Creating a Legacy. If you'd like to listen to any of the past 1,542 daily treks or read the associated journals, they are all available at wisdom-trek.com. And I encourage you to subscribe to Wisdom Trek on your favorite podcast player so that each day will be downloaded to you automatically. And thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, I am your friend, as I serve you through the Wisdom Track podcast and journal each day. And as we take this trek of life together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and create a great day every day. See you on Monday.